Russia's defense ministry has released a video in which witnesses of the aftermath of the alleged chemical attack in Syria's Douma say there was no indication that those rushed to hospital had been exposed to a chemical agent.
My name is Khalil Ajish. I am a medical student. I work in the ER department of Douma's Central Hospital. On April 8th, a building in the city was bombed. The upper floors were destroyed, and the bottom floors caught fire. All the injured from that building were brought to our hospital. The residents from the upper floors were suffering from smoke inhalation, and that is what we treated them for, based on the symptoms they exhibited.
This has been obviously dominating headlines over the past few days. That incident in Douma, whatever took place, has attracted very different versions of events from the Russian side, the Syrian side, and the US, UK, and France. Something did happen in Douma on the 7th of April with the Western nations and the White Helmets group on the ground in Syria claiming it was a chemical attack by the Damascus government on civilians, killing and injuring dozens. The Russian side, Damascus, saying this was all a setup. Now, today we've got that evidence allegedly from the Russian MOD saying they have identified an individual in the video you can see just being played there. That video was used as part of the evidence by the White Helmets and Western nations to prove that there was a chemical attack in Douma as those rebels and civilians were being evacuated. You can see the man highlighted, the witness there on the video, just for our viewers. They claim they've identified that man, found him, subsequently asked him exactly what happened in that incident on the 7th of April in Douma. Let's take a listen to what exactly he had to say about what took place in the hospital after that time.
During treatment, some person came in, I don't know who that was, and said that it was a chemical attack. People got scared. A fight broke out. Relatives of the victims started pouring water on one another. Others began to give inhalers for asthma to children, even though these people were not medical professionals. We did not see any patients exhibiting symptoms of chemical poisoning.
Now, this video, amongst others, of course, quite shocking, disturbing images of civilian casualties, was circulated online on social media and cited by the aforementioned organizations, countries, as evidence of that chemical attack. And evidence, of course, is the key word here. It's the real crux of the issue. We've got an OPCW team heading over to Douma on the way there. They should be there over the next 24, 48 hours or so. I believe they have arrived in Syria. Their findings will be key to establishing what really happened in Douma, whether there was some sort of chemical incident by the Damascus government, by Assad, as the Western nations are saying, or as we heard from the Russian MOD.
The Russian military has gathered evidence that indicates the direct involvement of Great Britain in organizing the provocation in eastern Ghouta. We know for a fact that London pressured the so-called White Helmets to carry out the planned provocation as soon as possible. They were told that from the 3rd to the 6th of April, rebels would carry out a series of heavy shellings of Damascus, and that this would lead to a reaction from the government forces, which the White Helmets should use for their provocation, and to allege the use of chemical weapons.
Now, these are obviously quite strong allegations from the Russian Ministry of Defense, or rather counter-allegations as to this alleged chemical incident in Douma, something they will have to obviously provide evidence for, specifically for Britain's involvement in this. The key bit of evidence, though, as we said before, is the arrival of the OPCW team with a UN man, that UN instructions on the ground to get those soil samples, get those air samples, examine any victims if there are any, and find out if any chemicals were used. That's the key thing to prove what exactly happened and to give gravitas and credibility to either of these two versions. We'll find that out, of course, in the next 24 to 48 hours.